blessed that you're here today, watching today. Today is what we call the Psycho Sabbato, which is the Saturday of the Souls, which is one of our wonderful traditions of the Orthodox, when we remember those who have passed before us, hopefully in the Kingdom of Heaven. It's a wonderful tradition because it keeps us intact with not only the physical world, but the spiritual world. And that's a reality. It's not something that that we think is, some people think that that might be morbid or what other things they might use. However, what it does is it connects us with not only those who have been loved ones who have passed before us, but it keeps us in touch with the memory, and it keeps us in touch with the Lord, knowing that He is the one who is the Savior, and everything depends on the Lord. So it's a wonderful tradition that we do that. We do it on four times a year, this what we call Saturday of the Souls, three times before Lent, two times before Lent, two Saturdays before Lent. Then when we enter Lent, we do another Saturday of the Souls. And this is the fourth and final one for the year. And this is the Saturday of the Souls, the day before Pentecost, which is tomorrow. So again, the beauty of it is, again, that it keeps us in the sense of reality, not denying, as our culture, our American culture, has a tendency to deny and push aside and not to remember death and that kind of thing, of which, again, is not natural and it's not normal, really. So our tradition is to keep that memory alive. I just was reading the obituaries the other day, and this woman wrote something about her husband, a very beautiful letter, and how much she missed him, and it was very beautiful. And it was not only her, it was the family. And apparently they do it every year because he had been he had died about 9 years ago or so. And it was very nice, it was very touching. However, we do it on a regular basis. Not that we remember do it all the time just for that purpose, but we do it when a person, of course, we have the burials, and then we have the 40 days. There's some traditions, you do it after 3 days, you can do it after 9 days, you can do it 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, and then a year, that we remember that person who has passed on before us. But in general, as the church, Psycho Sabbato, again, as today, is to remember those who have passed, on before us, keeping that memory alive, and we are alive. We don't believe that there is, who have passed before us are alive, and not in the body, but in the soul, and that we are in contact with each other still. We are in contact with each other still. So again, a very beautiful tradition of our church, and we keep it alive. It's been going on for 2,000 years, and there's good reason to continue on so we can understand that we are naturally alive in Christ in the body, and we are naturally alive in Christ when the body dies and the soul lives on forever and forever.
We worship you and glorify you and offer Glorified, we sing to you, hallelujah. Glorified. So εψυχαία αυτών εν αγαθείς αβυθίσονται. Προσέ Κύριε και κράξον με Θεό μου.
Σοφία.
Προς Θεσσαλονικής πρώτης επιστολής Παύλου στο Ανάγκητο.
Πρόσχομαι.
Αδελφοί, πού θέλουμε εμάς το γνωρίν, περί των κοιμημένων, ή να μην λυπήστε, καθώς και η λυπή ήμι έχω της ελπίδα. Ή θα πιστεύουμε ότι Ιησούς το πέφερε και ανέστη, ούτω και ο Θεός της κοιμηθέντας δια του Ιησού άξις είναι αυτό. Τούτο βάρη μην λέγουμε εν λόγω Κυρίου, ότι τιμή στις ζώντες οι περιεχόμενοι εις την παρουσία του Κυρίου ού εισπάσουμε τους κοιμηθέντας, ότι αυτός ο Κύριος εν κελεύσματι, εν φωνή αγγέλου και εν σάλπη του Θεού καταδικήσεται από τα ουρανού και οι νεκροί εν Χριστώ αναστήσονται πρώτο, έπειτα οι μισοί ζώντες, οι περιεχόμενοι, άμα συναυτής αρπαγιστόμεθα εν εφέλες, εις απάντησαν του Κυρίου εις αέρα και ούτω πάντοτε συν Κυρίου εσώμεθα.
Your soul shall dwell in prosperity. To you, O Lord, I have cried, O my God.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's first letter to the Thessalonians.
Let us be with him.
Brethren, we could not have you ignorant concerning those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, shall not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will be sent from heaven with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, with the sound of the trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we shall always be with the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Sofia, Sofia, posso le tue mani guardare a Dio, e le passi,
e non te fatti su.
E tu che te la muovi, la tua vita, la tua vita, la tua vita,
Σύ ακολουθεί με.
sin fe un logos putos iston apafus oti o apatikis etinos ut apokristi. Και ρούχ ήταν αυτό ο Ιησούς ότι ούχ απεσχνίστη. Αλλά αν αυτόν θέλω μένον Θεός έρχομαι τι προσέ. Ούτως εσκήν ο μαθητής, ο μαρτυρών περίπτωτον και γράψα σ' αυτά. Και είδομεν ότι αληθείς εσκήν ο μαρτυρία αυτού. Έστειδε και άλλος άλλα όσα επίσε ο Ιησούς. Απ' την άλλη αν γράφεται και γίνει, που δε αυτόν είναι το ποθό. Χωρίσε και γράφωμενα βιβλία Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these? He said to him, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. He said to him, Feed my sheep. A second time he said to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? He said to him, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. He said to him, Tend my lamb. He said to him the third time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter grieved because he said to him the third time, Do you love me? And he said to him, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. Jesus said to him, Feed my sheep. Truly, truly, I say to you, when you are young, you gird yourself and walk where you would. But when you are old, you will stretch out your hands, and another will gird you and carry you where you do not wish to go. This he said to show by what death he was to glorify God. And after this he said to him, Follow me. Peter turned and saw the disciple following whom Jesus loved, and who had laid him close to his breast at supper, and had said, Lord, who is it that is going to betray you? When Peter saw him, he said to Jesus, Lord, what about this man? Jesus said to him, If it is my will that he remain until I come, what is that to you? Follow me. So the word went out among the brethren that this disciple would not die. But Jesus did not say that this disciple would not die. He said, If it is my will that you remain until I come, what is that to you? This disciple who is bearing witness to these things and who has written these things, and we know that his testimony is true, but there are also many other things which Jesus did. Were every one of them to be written, I suppose the world itself could not contain the books that would have been written.
Thank you. Thank you.
mighty hand to us and to all of you.
Amen.
Αυτός και τα στιγμά στο νου
Ioannis, Despina, George, Dura, Spiros, Dimitrios, Maria, Dimitrios, Manolis, Ioannis, Ematia, George, Angela, Spiros, Richard, Elizabeth, Paul, George, St. Nadia, Robert, Richard, Robert, Julie, Reda, Perry, Natalie, Rose, Charles, Maria, Benjamin, Stan, James, George, Dorothy, Constantinos, Vasiliki, Dimitrios, Irene, Anastasias, Zacharias, Sophias, Theodoros, Dimitrios, Malikas, Prodromos, Yorgos, Zakharoulas, Elenis, Panayotis, Lidulas, Ephraimias, Panayot, Tenelotis, Andrianas, Elenis, Constantino, Constantino, Elias, Yorio, Sophias, Dimitriou, Sotirias, Dimosthenis, Christo, Constantinoas, Dimitrios, Dimitrios, Constantino, Marias, Constantinos, Marias, Gerasimos, Ois, Theophina, Panayotis, Elastelios, Chrysoulas, Alestis, Aleniches, Panayotis, Antonis, Dimitrios, Mardula, Γιώργος, Λιμόδης, Χρήστος, Ελένης Κύρος, Κώστα, Ευαθία, Φωτεινή, Μινάς, Βασιλική, Όδας, Κάρλ, Αντωνία, Έντζο, Τίλια, Νίκο, Ζέντερ, Μέρλι, Χαλ, Νίκος, Τζέιμς, Ιλίας, Κρίς, Ιμίλια, Ρος, Φίλο, Βίσκοπ, Στάλο, Κάρλος, Κάρλ, Martha, Laura, Vasiliki, Patrick, John, Nicholas, Julie, Christimas, Rena, George, Minas, Manipulas, Antonias, Antonias, George, Benardis, Panayotis, Metafia, Elenis, Michael, Michalis, Stephanis, George, Nicoleta, Panayila, Ελένης, Σάβας, Παρθενία, Κωνσταντίνος, Σοφίας, Μανόλ, Μανούλα, Σινέλα, Σπίρτα, Κωνσταντίνος, Ελένη, Ιωάννης, Ελένη και Εγώνιο, Γιώργος, Στίβενε και Εγώνιο, Ανέστης, Ματίας, Στίβιτο, Σουζάνα και Εγώνιο, Ευαγγέλου, Δημητρίου, Μιχαήλου, Εκατελήνης, Αντωνίου, Μαρτυρέλης και Εγωνέων, Νόρδος, Πασχημή και Εγωνέων, Μαρίνος και Εγωνέων, Νίκος, Μαρία και Τέκνων, Αρίστης, Ιερός, Καράλογος, Ευαγγελία, Αλεξάνδρος, Ανέστης, Jesus didn't know. He wanted Peter to affirm that he knew. And then it says, after he mentioned those questions, then he says, walk with me. And Peter begins to follow him, and he walks with him. And the other disciple, John, is following. And Peter says, who is that following us? Why is he following us? And Peter, and then Jesus says to him, it's none of your business, in a sense, a paraphrasing. He says, what is that to you? It's none of your business why he's following us. Just follow me. And then he went on and announced the essence of the gospel. So what does that, how does that apply to us? It applies to us that whatever anybody else does, whatever anybody else does is really not our business. In other words, oh, you see that person over there? That person is this, and they don't go to church, they do this, and look at all those people that go to church. What a bunch of hypocrites, many people say. Hypocrites! That's what they say. None of anybody's business. Who goes to church? Who doesn't go to church? That's up to that individual. That's why he says to Peter, who that disciple followed us? None of your business. If I said to him that he could have eternal life, that's what I would do. If I said to him anything else, that's the way it would be. But the people, and it was for us to say that it is I have to look at myself, Peter. That's why he asked Peter three times, do you love me? He didn't say, do you disciples love me? He asked it personally, do you love me? That's the question. The question is to all of us. Do you love God, Christ, Jesus? That's the question. Do you? And then whatever anybody else does is not in a business. But that's what he says. I want you, individually, to make the claim, and don't worry about anybody else. You're not any better. You're not any better in the eyes of God. God knows, God judges, and God will tell us. And we will find out on the last day. So I think it's a very good lesson for us. Peter, and why did he say to Peter? Because Peter was the one who denied him three times. Peter was the one who said, I will never leave you. I will never leave you. And then he denied Christ. And then he denied Christ. How many of us deny Christ in so many ways? Of not doing the things that we ought to do. We all do it to some degree. So not to judge anybody else, but to look at your own heart. I look at my own heart. Look at your own heart. And see, do you really love Christ? Do you really keep His commandments? Do you really love me, as he said to Peter? Do you really love me? And Peter had to say it three times. Yes, Lord. Not for Jesus' sake, but for Peter's sake. So Peter would know. And that's a good question for us. Lord, am I a true follower of you? Do I really love you as I ought to love? And that answer would come from Jesus. And we have to say to ourselves, yes, I do. Or whatever else the other answer would be. Whatever the answer would be. Again, I think a very profound lesson for us today in who we are in relation to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And may He bless you. May Christ help us, God, His good and loving and merciful God, have mercy on us and save us. Through the intercession of the most pure and holy Mother, the power of the precious and light gate of the cross, the protection of the earth and body, and the heart.